Breakfast Ball alongside Danny Parkins, Craig Carton. I am Mark Schlereth. Week 12 kicks off tonight. How are you guys doing? You ready?
I'm doing good, but there's an odor in the air.
Is there now?
Maybe you can smell it. It's called Concern in Kansas City.
Oh, is it? Well, that's where we shall start then, the Week 12 discussion. Concern in Kansas City. Chiefs at practice. There you see Patrick Mahomes right there. You know he leads the league in interceptions, right?
Yeah, exactly.
You do know that, right? 11 of them. No. They play the Panthers this week. Let me go to you, Danny, first. Biggest concern for Chiefs moving forward, my friend.
Well, I mean, there are some, which is, I think, the thing that you have to acknowledge because they've played so many close games, and I don't think that that's a bad loss, obviously. Buffalo's a top five team in the NFL, and they can win the Super Bowl, and it's not a bad loss to lose that game on the road, but they've had close games earlier, and then they lose that one. But I think pretty simply it's the offense. Their defense is clearly good enough to win a Super Bowl, and the offensive pedigree is clearly good enough to win the Super Bowl. But if you removed the picture of Patrick Mahomes and then the name at the top of the Chiefs, and I just said blank team offense this year,
right?
You'd be like, well, that offense can't win a Super Bowl.
Right. Sure.
Right.
You'd be like, is that the Raiders? Right? Is that like who would that be?
A middle of the pack team, and then all of those that were like the worst of Mahomes' career. So the biggest concern, we can get more micro if you want and say Pacheco coming back or Xavier Worthy or their stars having the worst years of their career. Like, it's the worst Mahomes has ever been. And that one at the bottom, yards per catch for Kelce. He's got no explosive plays.
Right.
Like, he's not a big play guy anymore.
And only had two catches in the Bills game, obviously.
Right. So, like, there's so many things. Maybe Pacheco coming back solves it. I don't know. But they need something to jolt that offense because, quite simply, right now, it's just not good
enough. Look, they don't say it, but they acknowledge that it ain't right because they brought in another wide receiver, a speed burner who's let go by New England.
Yeah.
I would not expect much out of him.
Tyquan Thornton.
Yeah, but they did bring another guy in. Look, getting Pacheco back to me is not a big deal because Hunt's been great. Like, their running game has not been a problem. But, you know, the Bills game, I don't think it exposed anything, to be fair about it. But it was the culmination of close game, close game, close game, close game.
Yep.
At some point, you're going to get bit in the rear end with a close game. Look, I don't think they're panicked, but I think when they go to bed at night, they know we are not a perfect team, and we may not even run the table from this point out. They'll beat Carolina.
Yeah.
They'll beat the Raiders. And then it does get interesting.
Well, here's where I fall on this is we look at the schedule right here.
Yeah.
Lost to Buffalo. They've got a couple of wins here in Carolina. The Raiders are not very good, but the Chargers are playing great.
Yep.
The Texans are, you know, no pushover. The Steelers, and then we don't know what's going to happen toward the end of the season, but the Broncos may be playing that Week 18 game
to get into the
playoffs. But there's this false narrative that goes on in the NFL right now that Travis Kelce has lost a step.
And, why is it a false narrative?
Well, it's a false. Well, let me explain.
Thank you.
Like, if you look
just
at his,
me up, kid.
Like, if you look at his statistics, right? His statistics. This is the worst through 10 games that he's ever played. 507 yards and two TDs. Look at every other year leading into this year. So this through 10 games, the worst start he has ever had. Okay,
that's like a factual narrative.
Well, sure, it's a factual narrative. But when you dig into the tape,
I can't wait for
and
the
you
twist
really there. Look at it. You watch how many times he faces double teams. Everybody in the league is bracketing him, trying to take him away. And the biggest issue to me with the Kansas City Chiefs is not that Travis Kelce has lost a step or he can't get open anymore or any of that stuff. It's that there's nobody else in the passing game that threatens you. So in critical situations, the one thing that teams are doing right now is double teaming him at all costs and leaving one-on-ones on the outside. And you know what? The one-on-ones aren't winning enough. They're not producing enough. It's the wide receivers that are not producing that's allowing teams to take Travis Kelce away.
I think that, obviously there is a lot of truth to that, but Travis Kelce also has been double-teamed his whole career.
Understood.
You know,
but let me tell you what happens, though. What happens is you get a double team early, but if Rashee Rice or somebody else is starting to eat you alive, guess where the double team shifts to?
No,
it shifts to those guys.
But he gets a lot of attention. His option routes have always been able to, like, he's a freelancer out there. This is so well documented, right? Like, run to the open space, Patrick Mahomes will find him. He's a second quarterback on the field. They seem to have this, like, telepathy, basically. Like, guys who are in their prime, Justin Jefferson gets a lot of double teams. Ja'Marr Chase gets a lot of double teams. Like, and they overcome it. And they still produce. So I think both things can be true.
But absolutely. But when you get double teams early, right, where your quarterback's eyes go to? They get off the double team. They come back to you late, but they get off the double team. They find somebody else. If those guys aren't open, right? It's
this is like a sign that like
I'm just telling you. In the last 4 years, when we want to point to the athleticism that Travis Kelce has lost or hasn't retained, that is a very small aspect of what's going on here.
Okay,
that's a very small aspect. He like to me, you watch him. He has all the ability in the world to continue to produce. It's just teams are taken away, and nobody else has really come to the forefront.
Like Worthy gets open but can't keep his feet in bounds. I guess that maybe changed the dynamic of the game and opens him up. But I'm sorry, Mark. I got to push back.
Go ahead.
They're panicking in Kansas.
Oh, he's still about it.
I'm telling you. All those one-score games, Travis Kelce, only two catches. Patrick Mahomes leads the league in interceptions. Josh Allen showed that Kansas City Chiefs defense ain't that good. Ooh. The problem for guys like me who are going to enjoy the demise of the Kansas City Chiefs.
Hey, trust me, man. I am right. I'm in your camp, man. Yeah. I am enjoying the demise.
Here's the problem.
9-1. Enjoy the 9-1 demise
of 9-1.
The problem with it is that for guys like us, not you, it's going to be short-lived because – wouldn't it be great if they played the Steelers this week or the Texans this week?
Yeah.
Like, they go from a loss as underdogs on the road to Buffalo to, we're going to make it up to you. We're going to give you a layup. Yeah, you get to play Carolina.
Well, that's how the script writers put it together.
Oh, thank you.
That's it. You're welcome. Hey, we talked about Week 12 kicking off. Well, it starts with the Steelers. There he is, Russell Wilson. 4-0 is the Steelers starter. The Steelers favored by 3.5 as they visit the Browns tonight, Thursday night football. So, Craig, are the Steelers legit AFC contenders?
Yeah, just like the Fat Boys, they're back. 80s reference. Anyway.
Yeah.
Undefeated.
I believe you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Damn it, I fear he was born in 87. No, look, they are absolutely contenders. They're not the best team in the AFC, but they're one of, if not the best defensive team in the AFC. They're getting competent quarterback play. All of a sudden, they're good for 100-plus yards on the ground every single week. George Pickens looks like the real deal again, like we thought after his rookie year, and they are a problem. So are they legitimate AFC contenders? Yes, they are.
Yeah, there's no question they are. And you talked about it. Great defense, right? Your ability to defend the run, your ability to get after the opponent's quarterback, they've got that.
And don't forget competent veteran quarterback.
Okay, I was getting to that. Just let me get to it. You're jumping the gun. Okay, so first off,
you're funny.
Great defense.
Thank you.
Great defense. Control the line of scrimmage, get to the quarterback, defend the run. They can run the football, and here's where they really set themselves apart.
Where's that?
And I'm going to go to Russell Wilson.
Thank you.
On the big plays in the offensive passing game. That's where they have set themselves apart. They are making two or three big-time throws down the sideline, and, you know, some of it is George Pickens just making unbelievable catches every week, but two or three big-time explosives down the sideline that put them either in scoring position or they score a touchdown on those things. And that's one thing that Russell Wilson has always had. He's been one of the best deep ball throwers in football. Okay. And that is coming to fruition. No question.
Okay. I mean, they're fine.
Wow.
Okay, against this Baltimore defense that struggled all year, that gave up 29 to the Browns, who plays Pittsburgh tonight. Pittsburgh didn't get the ball into the end zone once last week. Like they're very healthy on defense. Highsmith's been out. He's excellent, but he's coming back. Not tonight, but he'll be back soon. Their defense is great. Russ has connected on the deep ball. They haven't lost. I can't dispute any of that. But I don't know if division games can be trap games. Maybe you can speak to that.
Thursday night games can.
Thursday night on the road. Cleveland, this is weird. I'm not a trends guy.
Yeah.
Cleveland has won 8 straight home games on Thursday night, including 2 over Pittsburgh in the last 5 years.
Oh.
So division game on the road, coming off a big game against Baltimore. Weird things happen on Thursday. The weather is going to be miserable tonight. So a sloppy game. I'm not sold.
Hey there, thank you so much for watching Breakfast Ball. You know, you can subscribe right here to get all the latest bits and segments from our show. And hey, while you're at it, make sure to check out all the amazing content from all the other shows also right here on FS1.